कोविड के कारण पिछले दिनों हमने बड़े महत्वपूर्ण बंधु बांधवों को अपने बीच से जाते हुए देखा है। इस पीड़ा का एक और पड़ाव हमारे जीवन में अब न्यूयॉर्क में विशेष रूप से डॉक्टर अजय लोढ़ा के हमारे बीच न रहने से 21 नवंबर को उत्पन्न हुआ है। पिछले कुछ महीनों से वो कोविड-19 से जूझ रहे थे। जनवरी के महीने में अपने पुत्र का भारत में विवाह करके वो लौटे थे। मेडिकल की पढ़ाई करके वो सीधे अमेरिका कई वर्षों पहले जब आए थे तब उनका परिवार यहाँ पर था। फिर भी संघर्ष की यात्रा के साथ साथ अपने उत्साह का उन्होंने जिस तरह से समाज के सेवा के लिए प्रयोग किया वो अनुकरणीय है। डॉक्टर अजय लोढ़ा को 2016 में एलिस आइलैंड पुरस्कार से भी सम्मानित किया गया था। कई पुरस्कारों से सम्मानित डॉक्टर अजय ने अपना समर्पित नेतृत्व प्रदान किया महत्वपूर्ण संगठन आपी और राणा को भी। उनके नेतृत्व में बड़े महत्वपूर्ण आयोजनों को लोग आज भी याद करते हैं। एक आत्मीय संपदा के साथ साथ तत्परता से और उत्साह से सबकी सेवा के लिए आगे रहने वाले डॉक्टर अजय एक जिंदा दिल इंसान थे। उनके न रहने की कसक सभी महसूस कर रहे हैं और ये अवसर ऐसा है जब उनको श्रद्धांजलि और उनकी आत्मा की शांति की प्रार्थना के साथ साथ उनके बंधु बांधवों उनके परिवारजनों के अंदर उनकी अनुपस्थिति को सहन करने की शक्ति के लिए भी प्रार्थना करते हुए आप तक पहुंचा रहे हैं बातचीत का अंश जिसमें डॉक्टर अजय लोढ़ा अपने एलिस आइलैंड अवार्ड के बाद के दिनों में हमारे साथ ITV स्टूडियो में उपस्थित थे।
इट वॉज इंडीड अ वेरी वेरी गुड सेरेमनी एंड अ गुड एक्सपीरियंस टू बी इन देयर। द वे दे मेक यू मार्च ऑन द रेड कार्पेट, द वे द सेरेमनी इज हेल्ड, इट मेक्स यू फील वेरी पेट्रियोटिक ऑल्सो एट दैट टाइम, फुल ऑफ इमोशन। एंड यू नो द वे दे कंडक्ट द सेरेमनी बाई ऑल द you know military people are there, they are marching with you and they do patriotic songs. Okay, so this is how the ceremony was conducted really.
And when your name is announced, you your picture is displayed on the screen, people see you walking towards the dais. So was there any particular thought that you recollect which touched you as you were walking receive this medal, and when this was being conferred to you, literally any emotion that you may want to share?
I was very nervous, in one sentence I can tell you. It was very nervous, I don't worry one. When the name was announced, I just walked and you know, the picture was there and they gave us brief, you know, very short introduction of all the honorees they were giving, and the medal was given, photographs were taken. I can tell you, one of the best moments of my life, really, no doubt about it, definitely.
And it becomes even more special, as you mentioned, this is dedicated to immigrants, and that speaks of the spirit with which America welcomes and embraces with open arms and helps immigrants feel a part of this place, which indeed is a very special country in the whole world. It makes us not only proud of the country, but we also look back and think about the day when we landed here. So that point, it's a new birth in a way, because you are adopting total new environment, assimilating in a new cultural environment. And I still remember when someone, even when they're visiting America on tourist visa, they get visa, there is a sense of joy in them, in their family members, amongst friends. Walk us to that moment in your life when you decided that I'm going to America, you got the visa, you
You know, you hear a lot of stories, and there were a lot of people who had stories, who were telling their stories, you know, like the general secretary of this Mellicent Award, you know, NECO, this is known as NECO, who is there from last 18 years. He was telling us he came to this country with, I think, $2.50. And today, he's giving employment to 2,000 people. Okay, one of very rich people. So there were a lot of stories about a lot of different people. But fortunately, you know, I consider myself lucky that I did not come with $2.50. Friends were here. Okay.
Very good.
So I had a full support. But definitely, there was a big cultural difference. Finished my medical school. And as soon as I finished medical school, I landed here. It was the last day and first day. My last day of my medical school, the internship, and I was in the train. And I came here. And then the real struggle starts. You know, exactly a cultural difference, what you see from India as compared to here, in all the of the life. Okay. Really fascinated when I met our Prime Minister, Mr. Shri Narendra Modi ji. Some glow is there. And I really admire what he's doing. Okay. There is some criticism that, you know, things are not being done what he has promised. But you have to understand, you know, India is a big country with a lot of politics and a lot of problems. It's not electric switch. You come and turn on and off, things are being done. But I think he's going the right direction, definitely. We met with, you know, Amitabh Bachchan, who is a brand ambassador for RP. And, you know, during President Ravi Jagirdar's time, who started this traumatic brain injury program, which Amitabh Bachchan became the brand ambassador, and he came to RP. He was with us for 4 or 5 hours. Okay. It was a very fascinating moment when we had individual photographs and he was mingling with us, really. And whatever we asked him at that time, and free of cost, okay. And he was what we are doing. And we are carrying this traumatic brain injury program. And